The most common form of nutritional deficiency worldwide is iron deficiency anemia, or IDA. Now, IDA is associated with things like decreased school performance, increased behavioral issues, and overall negative outcomes for children. The World Health Organization estimates that 40% of preschool-aged children have IDA. So what's the cure? Well, it's simple. Eating more iron-rich foods like beef, beans, or tofu, or adding an iron supplement into your day can get you right back to where you need to be. So if the cure is so simple, why are so many people still struggling? Well, it's a diagnostic issue. You see, the way an IDA diagnosis is supposed to work is you go to the doctor, get your blood drawn, they check your hemoglobin levels, which is the main diagnostic indicator of IDA. The doctor tells you what your levels are, and then you make lifestyle changes to address those. But think about all the things that go into a blood draw. You have to transport yourself to the medical center. Once there, there has to be trained medical staff to do the draw. You have to have sterile equipment. Once the blood is drawn, it has to be kept cool and transported to a lab for testing. That lab has to have the reagents, the tools, the equipment to do the test. And then the doctor has to communicate with you what the results were, meaning another trip to the medical center. Now imagine you're one of the 400 million people worldwide that doesn't have access to quality medical care. A child presenting with fatigue is just not going to get a blood draw. It's way too resource intensive. So how do we fix this? Well, I believe the answer is similar to what a lot of you have on your wrist right now. If you look on the back of any modern smartwatch, you'll see some lights and some light detectors. And while your smartwatch probably can't measure hemoglobin, it can measure other physiological things like heart rate or blood oxygen. And the way it does that is these special lights shine into your tissue, they interact with your tissue in a known way, that interaction is measured, and then they can make estimates about those physiological factors. And we can do something similar. If we shine a special wavelength of light into your tissue, we can again measure that interaction and estimate your hemoglobin values non-invasively, eliminating the need for the resources that would go into a blood draw. And that's what I've been working on for the past 2 years. On this slide, you see one of our earliest prototypes, and while there are some issues with it, we got some really exciting and promising results. Now, this is what I like to call a soft issue. And to me, a soft issue is anything in which it's not technology development that's gating people's access to the solution, it's social issues. So in the case of IDA, we have a great diagnostic indicator, the blood draw. But the social issue of access to healthcare is blocking people from getting to that solution. And as we look around the world today, there are millions of soft issues that need to be solved. So I hope today, as you go out into the world and you create and engineer and design, you keep a special eye out for those soft issues and incorporate those into your designs. How much better would the world be if we created solutions for everyone, not just for those who have access to the latest technology? Thank you.